Hello children, welcome to today's class. Hope you all are safe, healthy and happy at home. You need to really take care of yourself at this time of the pandemic and also take care of your family members. It's very important. As you're at home and learning, you must devote a lot of time in practicing the different exercises which are given to you after every class. Children, in the last two classes we had learnt about the tenses, the present and the past tense. Today we'll be learning about the future tense. As I had told you before that we will be looking at the tenses separately, like in one of the classes we just focused on the present tense, and in the next class we focused on the past tense, and today we'll be focusing on the future tense, okay, so that the concept becomes clear to you. And as I told you, you need not bother very much about the rules. As you practice lot of exercises, the rules will be clear to you. And let me tell you children, this year the board has introduced the workbook in English for you, Words and Expressions, for class 9 and for class 10th. So all the grammar topics which you have in your syllabus for 9th and 10th, the exercises in your workbook are based on these grammar topics. So as I cover the grammar topics for you in different classes, you can look into your workbooks and practice the exercises related to each grammar topic. The moment we finish the future tense, we will be covering the topic tense, and you can look into your worksheets for the exercises related to tenses. This year in your topic you have editing, you have close passage, and you have dialogue writing and reporting dialogue. So in all these different types of exercises, all the grammar topics mentioned in your syllabus will be covered. Therefore, in your grammar book, separate exercises are there for different grammar topics. So it will help you to understand the topics better once you practice these exercises. So let's try to understand the future tense today. Please look at your screen very carefully, and you can also click pics of the tables and examples which I'll be explaining to you, and also please listen carefully and try to understand. The simple future tense. The simple future tense is used when an action is promised or thought to occur in the future. That means the future tense talks about a time in the future that is going to come, or action that is going to happen in future. We have not seen the future, so we are not very sure about the future. We know our past and we know what is happening in the present, but we are not very sure about the future. We just make plans for the future. Okay, so the simple future is used to talk about some action which is going to take place in the future, and the structure would be subject plus shall or will plus verb plus object or the complement. Okay, subject, the person or thing or place we are talking about, and then shall or will. When you talk about the future, you make use of shall or will, plus verb, the first form of the verb, or we say the verb in the present, and then the object or the complement. Okay, now let's look at some of the examples. We shall move to another city. That means we have not yet moved, we are going to move to a new city. He will come to New York tomorrow. As I told you, for present we say today, for the past we say yesterday, and for the future we say tomorrow. So, he'll come to New York tomorrow. He has not yet come. So, he will. We shall. They will make a phone which has artificial intelligence. That means they have not yet made a phone with artificial intelligence. They are going to make it in the future. So, they will make, he will come, and we shall move. So, these are the examples of the simple future tense. Right? And let me repeat the structure once again for you. The subject plus shall or will plus verb plus object. Okay? Now, let's move to the future continuous tense. The future continuous tense is used when an action is promised or thought to continue for some time in the future or to go on for a specific time in the future. Right? The present continuous action which is going on when we are talking. Past continuous, the action which continued for some time in the past. Now, the future continuous is an action that is going to continue for some time in the future. Let's look at the structure. It is subject plus shall or will plus be plus verb plus ing. The first form of the verb plus ing, and then it could be the object and the or the complement. Okay, some action which is going to continue for a specific time in the future. That is future continuous tense. For example, I shall be sleeping at around 6 a.m. tomorrow. So, when it will be 6 a.m. tomorrow, I shall be sleeping. That means I will continue to sleep at that time, at that particular time. I'll be sleeping. Okay? They will be playing at this time tomorrow. Tomorrow at this time they are going to continue playing for some time. Okay? So they will be playing. She will be watching TV when I come home. When I come home, she will continue watching the TV. Okay, her action will go on. She will watch TV for some time in the future. Okay, I will be working in the office while you watch a movie. While you watch a movie, my action in the office will continue for some time. I'll continue working for some time in the office. So, children, the ing form. The ing form of a verb tells us that an action continues for some time. It goes on. Okay? So, the present continuous, the past continuous, and the future continuous, all three forms have the ing form. Okay? So, the structure once again, it is subject plus shall or will plus be plus ing. Now, the future perfect tense. The future perfect tense is used to demonstrate an action which is promoted, which is promised to be done by a certain time in the future. As I had told you, perfect means complete. Present perfect means an action that is completed. I have finished my work. Completed in the present. Completed. Complete. Perfect means the action is complete. Past perfect, had done my homework. Action had been completed in the past. Now, future perfect tense means some action which is going to be completed in future. Let's look at the structure. Subject plus shall or will plus have plus verb in the past participle plus object. The sentence continues. So, verb in the third form. Or in the past participle. I had discussed with you about the third form of the verb. Done, seen, told, asked, given, okay? So all the perfect tense have the third form of the verb, the present perfect, the past perfect and the future perfect, okay? So subject plus shall or will plus have plus third form of the verb. So let's look at the example. I shall have completed the assignment by Monday. I shall have completed. Completed is the third form of complete. Complete, completed, completed. So I shall have completed the assignment by Monday. By next Monday, my assignment would be complete. She will have cleaned the house before her father comes. Before her father comes. Now her father has not come home. Before he comes, she will have cleaned the house by that time. Alex will have submitted the tender by tomorrow. By tomorrow, he will have submitted the tender. Before I go to see her, she will have left the place. Leave, left, left. The third form of the verb. They will have finished making the bridge by January. By January, they will have finished making the bridge. So some action which is going to be perfect or complete in the future or promised to be done in the future. So that is the future perfect tense. Now let's look at the future perfect continuous tense. The structure is subject plus will or shall plus have plus been plus ing form. Okay? In the perfect we had have plus the third form. Perfect continuous have plus been plus ing form. Okay, let's look at the examples. He will have been writing a letter. She will have been singing a song. They will have been digging a hole. He will have been writing a letter. In future, he will continue to write a letter for some time. Okay, he was writing a letter. That's not complete and he is going to continue that in future. Future perfect continuous. Okay. So the future perfect continuous also talks about an action going on over a period of time that will end in the future. For example, when he gets his degree, he will have been studying in Cambridge for 4 years. By next week, we shall have been doing this job for 6 weeks. By 1998, she will have been ranking the first. Okay? Some action which will go on for some time in future. Okay? Till the time the action ends, it will be continued. That is the future perfect continuous tense. I hope children the four different forms of the future tense is clear to you. Now children, we have learnt all the three different kinds of tenses. The present, the past and the future. Now let's quickly look at the table of the tenses, all the three tenses and try to understand them quickly. All three of them together so that you understand all the three tenses properly. Okay, so we'll be looking at one particular sentence and we will be looking at all the three different forms. Okay, now this particular table has got the verb write. Okay, look into the table very carefully. The first column is the tense, the present, the past and the future. And here it is the simple, the continuous, the perfect and the perfect continuous. Now, the present tense, okay, we'll be looking at all the three forms, okay. Now, the present, simple present tense, the structure is subject plus the first form of the verb in the present. So, he writes a letter. Since he is singular, we have used the S form, he writes a letter. Now, continuous, it is subject plus am or is or are plus the ing form of the verb. So, he is writing a letter. The perfect is subject plus has or have plus the third form of the verb or the past participle. He has written a letter. The perfect continuous, the form is subject plus has or have plus been plus ing form. Okay, he has been writing a letter. Now, he writes a letter. He is writing a letter, he has written a letter, he has been writing a letter. The simple, the continuous, the perfect and the perfect continuous. Okay, so if you look at the table at a glance, it's going to give you an idea of all the three different tenses and their four different forms. Okay, now the past. Simple past is subject plus the second form of the verb or the verb in the past. He wrote a letter. Wrote is the past tense of write. Now, continuous is subject plus was or were plus the ing form. So, he was writing a letter. The perfect, past perfect is subject plus had plus third form or the past perfect. So, he had written a letter. Now, the past perfect continuous is subject plus had plus been plus ing form. He had been writing a letter. Okay. Now, the future, the simple future is the subject plus will or shall plus the first form of the verb. He will write a letter. Continuous, subject plus will or shall plus be plus ing form. He will be writing a letter. The future perfect, subject plus will or shall plus have plus the third form. He will have written a letter. Now, the future perfect continuous, subject plus will or shall plus have been plus ing form of the verb. That is, he will have been writing a letter. Okay? Right? So, let's quickly try to understand the three tenses and the four different forms. How you are going to revise? Okay? When you look at all the three tenses together, it will help you to remember the structure also or the forms. Okay? For example, when you say the simple tense, right? Simple present, simple past, simple future. Now, let's go like this. He writes a letter. He wrote a letter. He will write a letter. Simple of all the three tenses. Okay. Now, the past. He is writing a letter. He was writing a letter. He will be writing a letter. Now, the perfect. He has written a letter. He had written a letter. He will have written a letter. Now, the perfect continuous. He has been writing a letter. He had been writing a letter. He will have been writing a letter. So, if you look at the simple continuous perfect and the perfect continuous in this way also, it will help you to understand the tenses in a better way. Okay. Now, here I have taken one example, that is the verb write. You can practice this table by taking different verbs. Okay. Dance, work, sing, okay, came or come, came, come the three different forms. You can take different verbs, teach, okay. So take different verbs and try to practice as we did in this particular table. So the more you practice with more verbs, the more perfect you will become in the understanding of the tenses, and this will help you to do the exercises related to tense in a better way. Now let's try to look at one simple exercise related to the tense. Your exercises related to the grammar will have all the grammar topics in them. Those exercises are the close passage. You can be asked to edit a given passage. You can be asked to complete a dialogue, and you can also be asked to report a dialogue. So in writing dialogues or in reporting dialogues or in editing, there might also be some sentences related to the tenses. So if you understand the tenses properly, you will be able to do these exercises without any mistake. So we'll try to do one simple exercise. Now look at the question very carefully on your screen. Complete the paragraph with the suitable tense of the verbs. Choose the correct form of the verb and write the answer against the correct blank in your answer sheets. So this is the kind of question you're going to get. Now there are options, and this particular exercise is based on tenses. Okay, now let's try to look at each sentence and try to write the correct option. As the years blank by, we saw less of each other. Okay, so look at the verb there, saw, S-A-W. So which tense is it? It is the past tense of see. So you should try to understand. So this line talks about the past tense. Okay, some action which has happened. So look at the option 1, roll, rolled, and is rolling. It will not be roll, it is a present tense. Rolling is the continuous, so it has to be rolled. As the years rolled by, we saw less of each other. So look at the second sentence. For some time, she, there's a blank, to wake me up and get me ready for school. Okay, look at the options. Continue, continued, is continuing. It is not talking about an action which is continuing now or which will continue in future. It talks about some action which continued in the past. So for some time she continued to wake me up and get me ready for school. So this happened in the past, past habit. So the simple past tense, continued. Okay, when I, there's a blank, back, she would ask me what the teacher, there's a blank, me. Okay, now look at the third option, came, come, coming. Since the passage talks about some past action, something that happened in the past, so it will not be come, okay, and it will not be coming because it is a continuous action. So when I came back, okay, she would ask me what the teacher, now look at option 4, had taught, taught, and teach. Okay, now please look at this sentence very carefully, children. When I came back, okay, she would ask me what the teacher, there's a blank, me. So this particular sentence has got two actions. Okay, one is I came back from school, and the second is she asked me something. So there are two actions. Okay, do you remember what I had told you? When there are two actions in a sentence, the action that happened first would be the past perfect, so had plus third form, and the second action would be the simple past tense. That is why first the teacher had taught in the class, then she came home, okay, came back. So here, when I came back, she would ask me what the teacher had taught me. Clear? Now look at the next sentence. I would tell her English words and little things of Western science. Now look at option 5. Okay? Has made, make, made. Okay? This her unhappy. That means when she told her what the teacher had taught, that is English words and little things of Western science, so this, there is a blank, her unhappy. So what would be that? This made her unhappy. Simple past tense. Okay? She, there is a blank in the things they, again there is a blank at the English school. Okay? Look at option 6. Believed, did not believe, does not believe. Now she, in the things they, look at 7, option 7, had taught, has taught or taught. So here, in the last sentence we saw this made her unhappy. So she did not believe in the things they taught at the English school. That means she was not happy at what was being taught. So she did not believe, okay, in the things they taught at the English school, and was distressed that there, again there is a blank, no teaching about God and the scriptures. So look at the options here, is, was and be. So definitely she is talking about some practice that is taking place in English school. So she was distressed that teaching is, okay, again singular, and we are talking about the past, so there was no teaching about God and the scriptures. The options were is, was and being. Being we use whenever we use the continuous tense. So children, when we practice these exercises, you might have observed what are the points you have to keep in mind while you are doing exercises related to tenses. You need to quickly look at the sentences and bring to your mind the different tenses, the forms, okay, the situations where we use the different tenses, the present, the past and the future. Okay, so when you practice more exercises from your workbook, the uses of tense will become more clear to you. As I told you, practicing more exercises will make you more perfect. Now children, let's try to look at some points you need to keep in mind while you are looking at the different forms of the tenses and you are practicing exercises related to tenses. We had already discussed about be. See, many a times in the option you might get be. Okay? So be has got different forms. For example, is, are, was, were and be. Okay? So if you have got be as an option, if be is there in the bracket with the tenses related exercises, or you have be in the option, then you need to look at the tense if it is in the present tense, or if the particular line or the next line talks about the present tense, then you have to use is. And again, is with, you must remember, the singular verb. And if it is plural, then you have to use are. Okay? Is with singular and are with plural. That is when you have be. Okay? Many a time, you get confused if there is this word in the option. as to what you are supposed to write. So if the passage talks about the present tense, then for singular you will write is, and for plural you will write are. And if the passage talks about the past tense, okay, and you have be. So for singular it will be was, and for plural it will be were. Okay, and then you know being, as it has got ing, it talks about some action being continued. Okay, so we know that being, okay, something is being done, some action is continuing, so the ing form, that work was being done. Okay, so if you see that there is a continuous sentence or the continuous form, some action is continuing, then we are using the word be. So I hope now you have understood the different uses or in the different forms of be which you might get in your exercises. And then you also have to be very clear about the singular and plural, and also the different tenses which you are going to use. We have, for example, have. Okay? For example, I have. We have. They have. You have. Okay? I had told you before also that I will have the plural form. I do, I go, I play, I have. Okay? We, again, if you look at this, okay? As I told you, you in English, this is used for one person and at the same time for many persons also. Okay, I had told you, you, that means when we talk of one person. Are you going to the market now? Are you tired? Can you help me? If we talk to one person. When we talk to a group of students also, we say you. How are all of you? Did you all complete your homework? You all must have seen this movie. When we address a group of people also, we say you. So you must remember these simple things. They are very important, because sometimes you commit mistakes in the use of these simple verb forms. Okay. And then when we say he has, she has. Okay. That means for one person we say has. Is it clear? So these things have to be very clear. And when we are using the present perfect, so has or have plus third form. Okay, the present perfect will have has or have plus third form. That you have to be very clear. Has, have. Again, has for singular and have for plural. Okay. But when we are talking about the future tense, just we had tried to understand about the future tense, will or shall plus have. I shall have completed my work. So there you have I shall have, they shall have, we shall have. Okay, So this you have to be very careful. When here we had talked for the present perfect has or have, and for the past perfect had plus third form. So these are some of the points you need to remember. For the past perfect we will have I had, they had, she had, we had, okay, that is common, had plus third form. For future, he shall have, they shall have, I will have, okay, that is have. And in the present perfect it is has for singular and have for plural. So these things you need to be very careful, because you sometimes may be in a hurry, make mistakes even while solving the simple exercises. So I hope children the tenses are very clear to you now. In the next class we'll learn some other grammar topic. Until then I hope you will look into your workbook if you have one with you, or you can practice some exercises from your grammar book also. In the next class we will meet with some other grammar topic. Until then, take care, stay safe, stay at home.